Welcome to Math Adventures. Today, we will be talking about how to add fractions. In this video, we will talk about adding fractions with the same denominators, adding fractions with different denominators, adding mixed numbers, and adding a mixed number to a proper fraction. Let's talk about adding fractions with the same denominators. We have two boxes with oranges. In the first box, we have 6 oranges, but there is space in the box for 12 oranges, so we can write it as 6/12. The second box has 5 oranges, but there is space for 12 oranges, so we can write it as 5/12. Now, let's move all our oranges to one box with space for 12 oranges. We move 6 oranges, and then we move 5 more. So in total, we have 11 oranges in a box with space for 12 oranges. Thus, we can write it as 11/12. Let's repeat what we did. We had 6 oranges in a box with space for 12 oranges, or 6/12, if written as a fraction. And we wanted to add to that 5 oranges from another box with space for 12 oranges, or 5/12. So we would have all our oranges in one box with space for 12 oranges. We added 6 oranges from the first box with space for 12 oranges, and then 5 oranges from the second box that has space for 12 oranges as well. 5 + 6 = 11. So now we have 11 oranges in a box with a space for 12 oranges, or 11/12. Did you notice that we only added the numerators, but the denominator did not change? When we add fractions with the same denominators, we only have to add the numerators. Let's practice. How much is 3/8 + 2/8? Both fractions have the same denominators, so we only need to add the numerators. In this example, 3 + 2 = 5. It means 3/8 + 2/8 is equal to 5/8. Now, let's talk about adding fractions with different denominators. How should we add two fractions that have different denominators? To answer that question, let's review what a fraction is. A fraction means a whole is divided into equal parts. The denominator of a fraction tells us the number of parts in a whole. In our example, one whole is divided into 6 equal parts, and the other whole is divided into 4 equal parts. The whole that was divided into 6 parts has more parts than the whole divided into 4 parts. To add two fractions with different number of parts that have different denominators, we have to find a way to make each denominator or number of parts in a whole the same in each fraction before adding. This is where equivalent fractions come handy. And to review what is an equivalent fraction, watch our video about equivalent fractions on our channel. In our example, each whole needs to have 12 equal parts, so we can rewrite both fractions as equivalent fractions with the same or common denominator. Thus, we can rewrite 5/6 as 10/12 and 1/4 as 3/12. As each fraction now has the same denominator, that is number of parts in a whole, we can add our parts together. 10/12 + 3/12 = 13/12. And that we can write as a mixed number of 1 and 1/12. To find common denominator, we have to find what is known as least common multiple. Let's see how we can do that. In our example, we have one fraction with 6 in the denominator, and the other fraction has 4 in the denominator. Let's list multiples of 4 and 6. So we have 8, 12, 16, 20, and 24 as multiples of 4. And for 6, we have 12, 18, 24, 30, and 36. If we look closer, we notice that number 12 and number 24 appear as multiple, both for number 4 and number 6. So, number 12 and number 24 are common multiples for number 4 and 6. And what does it mean to find least common multiple? Least means that we have to use for common denominator the smallest number that is a common multiple. 12 is smaller than 24, so number 12 is the least common multiple for 4 and 6, and we will use it as a common denominator. As we said before, to add 5/6 and 1/4, we will have to represent those fractions as equivalent fractions with a denominator of 12. To do that, we have to multiply 6 in the denominator of the first fraction by 2, as 6 times 2 is 12. Since we multiply the denominator by 2, we also have to multiply the numerator of this fraction by the same number, so we multiply 5 by 2. The denominator in the second fraction needs to be multiplied by 3 to have 12. As we multiply denominator by 3, we have to multiply numerator by 3 as well. 5 times 2 is 10. 6 times 2 is 12, and that gives us 10 over 12 for the first fraction. 1 times 3 is 3. 4 times 3 is 12. So we have 3 over 12 for the second fraction. Now we have fractions with the same denominators, and we can add them by adding numerators only. So 10 plus 3 is 13, and the denominators stay the same. Thus, 5/6 plus 1/4 is 13/12, or 1 1/12. Let's talk about adding mixed numbers. How should we add mixed numbers? To add mixed numbers, we can first add whole numbers and then add fractions. In our example, we would add 1 and 2 together first, and then 4/5 and 1/2. So 1 plus 2 is 3. This way, we have 3 plus 4/5 plus 1/2. Now we can add 4/5 plus 1/2 and add the result to 3. To add 4/5 to 1/2, we first need to find common denominator. In our example, it is 10. That way, we have 8/10 plus 5/10. And 8/10 plus 5/10 equals to 13/10. 13/10 is an improper fraction. How do we know it's an improper fraction? Watch our video on improper fractions to find out. So 13/10 is equal to 1 3/10. And 3 plus 1 and 3/10 is equal to 4 3/10. Let's repeat what we did. First, we added the whole parts, and next, we found a common denominator, which is 10. Then, we represented 4/5 and 1 second as an equivalent fraction with common denominator of 10. To do that, we multiply denominator and numerator of 4/5 by 2 and denominator and numerator of 1 second by 5. Next, we added 8/10 and 5/10. 13 over 10 is equal to 1 3/10. So, 3 plus 1 and 3/10 is 4 3/10. It means 1 4/5 plus 2 1 second is equal to 4 3/10. Now, let's talk about adding a mixed number to a proper fraction. What should we do to add a mixed number to a proper fraction? We can rewrite 4 3/8 as 4 3/8. That way, we have 4 3/8 plus 1/4. And now, we add fractions, that is 3/8 and 1/4 first. And then, we add to that sum 4. The common denominator for 3/8 and 1/4 is 8. So then, we have 4 3/8 plus 2/8. And 3/8 plus 2/8 is 5/8. Four plus 5/8 is equal to 4 5/8. Let's repeat what we did. First, we rewrote 4 3/8 as 4 3/8. And then, we found common denominator for 3/8 and 1/4, which is 8. That way, we have 4 3/8 plus 2/8, and that is equal to 4 5/8. So, 4 3/8 plus 1/4 equals to 4 5/8. Let's repeat what we had talked about today. When adding fractions with the same denominator, we only add numerators. Denominator does not change. For example, 3/7 plus 2/7 equals 5/7. When adding fractions with different denominators, we have to rewrite fractions we are adding as equivalent fractions with the same denominators. To find common denominator, we need to look for the least common multiple. We do that by creating a table with multiples for numbers in the denominators. For example, to add 3/8 and 1/6, we have to rewrite those fractions as equivalent fractions with the same denominator. The least common multiple for 6 and 8 is 24. Next, we multiply both numerator and denominator by the multiplier needed to obtain the least common multiple. So we have to multiply numerator and denominator of a first fraction by 3, and we have to multiply numerator and denominator of a second fraction by 4. Thus, we have 9/24 plus 4/24, and that is equal to 13/24. To add mixed numbers, first we add whole parts, and then we add fractions. For example, to add 1 3/7 and 3 2/7, first we add 1 3, which is 4. And then we add 3/7 2/7 to the 4. So we have 4 5/7. To add a proper fraction to a mixed number, we can add fractions first, and then add that to the whole number. For example, to add 6/7 and 3 2/7, we add 6/7 2/7 first. 6/7 plus 2/7 is 8/7, and that is 1 1/7. and we add that to 3. So the total is 4 1/7. That's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you soon in the next math adventure. And remember, math is fun.